Hello, I'm Mr. Arnitya, a retired lecturer in mythology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Today I was thinking to tell you about the mother of Jesus. Mary wasn't the mother of Jesus. His real mother is Holy Spirit. Now, first you should know the family of God, then you will appreciate what I am talking. In the family of God, we have God is our Father, and Holy Spirit is our Mother, and the one who represents Father is always a Son. So whether in flesh you are a male or a female, it doesn't matter. Because in Jesus, your soul, spiritual self, which is the supernatural, that counts. So this, our flesh, belongs to natural father, natural tribal father. Our soul belongs to our spiritual father, one only we have, one father. And we are all his sons, whether you are a male or female in flesh. But you must become the master of your own destiny. When you become master of your own destiny, then you follow none. Now, Saul, when he was the disciple of Gamaliel, he wasn't the master of his own destiny. He was doing what his ruler, Gamaliel was telling him to do. Whether it was wrong or right, he just did it. Now, in persecution of the laborers of Jesus, Saul wasn't happy at all, but as Gamaliel has told him to persecute them, to finish them off, he was doing it. Remember in the synagogue, Sanhedrin, when they were discussing about Jesus, that he is made the Lazarus to alive again after 4 days, when the high priest and everybody were very furious, he said, there's no need to be furious, you know. Somebody, you know, started some campaign 200 years ago, this and that, you know. And that slowly died off. So this also, you know, it's there. Slowly it will die off. And you don't need to worry. So they listened to him. And then they cool down a little bit. So this to die it off, that is what he was instructing his disciple Saul, to persecute the laborers of Jesus so they could be dissuaded and brought into the Judaism, back into Judaism, which they did not succeed. So, under the rabbinic God Yahweh is alienated. He is not real. He is demiurge. This flesh belongs to Yahweh, but what makes it living, my soul, that comes from my Father God. Supernatural. So without supernatural, this is no good. So supernatural is the dominant over the God of flesh, which we call Demiurge, Yahweh. In India, we call him Brahma. In Arabic, they call it Khuda. And the one who is inside me, invisible. Remember, the Greek told had the vision of this God, invisible, which is invisible, you can't see. That one is called Par Brahm. Par means super. Brahm means same as Brahma. So supernatural. In Hebrew they call him Elohim. In Arabic they call him Allah. To the Brahma they call him Khuda. So in the whole world, you know, wherever there is a clear-cut concept about the visible and invisible, what is born of flesh is flesh. Flesh is visible. So the God of flesh is Yahweh. And this is natural. And he is jealous and revengeful as the people of flesh are. They only love their own type, arrows. It is only when you become a spiritual person, then when you realize that when you were born, that it wasn't born in a, you were born in a certain family, male or female, of your own choice. It was the choice of our Father, wherever he put the soul. My soul was put in India, Punjab, in a male body. Somebody's could be put in Africa, in a female body. Somebody in America, Britain, Brazil, all over the world. In a dog, animal, the same soul. So when you realize that we have one Father, God, and we are people of different color because of the different clay. Different clay, different color. Somewhere the clay is white, somewhere it's black, somewhere it's brown. So you have different colors. Animals, different form, different pot. The Brahma is sometimes called potter. Potter who makes the utensils. Some are made round, some are this shape, some are that shape. So similarly, we are the body. This shape, one dog, another shape, horse, another shape. So the one that makes its living and the one who infused the soul into the pots or into the clay, he is our real Father God. Supernatural. So Jesus came from our supernatural Father because these people, rabbis, who serve the natural Father Yahweh, they became spiritually blind. Oral Torah make you the son of a supernatural Father. So the knowledge of oral Torah was missing among the greedy rabbi. Rabbi became greedy and hypocrite. They were not worshipping God in truth and in spirit. So they were worshipping Satan, hypocrite they became. So the knowledge of the oral Torah got missing. Oral Torah, God, our Father is loving and merciful. And Sabbath is the day that was devoted to work for our Elohim God, which is spirit. But they were sitting quiet, not even taking their animal, they would take it for a drink of water, you know. But they won't go into the field to cut the grass or anything. Even in England, you know, the house catches fire on Sabbath. They will call their rabbi what they should do instead of putting it off. Doctors are sitting at home, not using their medical skill for philanthropic work. Because no money, no work. So they have no philanthropic sense at all. So in our Father God, God is our Father. That's why we can inherit His royal kingdom. If we call our Father a Lord, as Yahweh is Lord, and His priest, they are also Lord in His name. They are rulers. Our Father is loving and merciful, and so His sons are super servants like Christ Jesus. He came to serve us, not to rule over us. So in Jesus we serve people, not rule over them. So you have in Jesus, our Father is God, He is not Lord. Lords have slaves. Slaves are not allowed into the house or to inherit the property. So you have to be His son in order to enter the house of our Father and enjoy their company, where Christ Jesus is sitting there in the vineyard of our Father. You have to get through the narrow gate, which is solid for the solitary. No two person can enter through that one. And you have to find it. You have to seek it. And you find it by the grace of our Father. Nobody can find that gate unless our Father willeth. So you have Father. Now Father is, you know, He doesn't speak. He gives you protection. If you are in trouble, then He will protect you. Then who speaks then? Our Mother speaks, Holy Spirit. She is the mouthpiece of our Father. So when Jesus was baptized by John the Baptist, then he baptized him in the name of Yahweh, because his name is Jesus. Jesus is from Yeshua. Yah is from Yahweh. Shua is Adam. So his natural father, our heavenly father, was Yahweh. So when he was baptized in the name of Yahweh. Then our Mother, Holy Spirit, said, "This is my son. Listen to him." So the father of Jesus, this one father, fleshly Jesus, father of Jesus, was Yahweh, and our supernatural father, in the beginning was the Word. Word wanted the flesh. So Word is Christ. So the Father of Christ, which was inside His heart, he is God, our supernatural Father, and His Mother is Holy Spirit. Real Mother is Holy Spirit. And this Mother in flesh, Mary, she is the surrogate Mother of Jesus. She carried the seed of Yahweh to produce Yeshua, son of Yahweh, the second Adam. So that's why in Jesus always addressed Mary as a woman and not as mother. But these Messianic Jews, they have corrupted the Old and the New Testament, and they introduce somewhere that, when he was dying, you know, "Look, your son is dying." That's wrong, you know. Son, first, she was the surrogate mother. And so Joseph was the foster father. So he was the son of Yahweh, who was crucified on the cross by the rabbis. So Rabbis were devoid of mean, empty of oral Torah. They were lacking oral Torah, so Jesus came to deliver them the knowledge of the oral Torah. So that's why when Jesus was in the synagogue, he possessed both the knowledge of the scripture and the oral Torah. So then he was teaching in the synagogue. You explain, you know, the scripture. When you explain the scripture, you are a teacher. So he was teaching them in the synagogue with the background knowledge of oral Torah. And that is what he did in Jerusalem when he was 12 years old. He was explaining to the doctors of law the basics or the roots of the moral laws. Moral law is a tree that you can see apply on here. But the roots of the moral laws, they are oral Torah or his word. If these are dead, then moral laws are dead. That means letter killeth, spirit giveth life. So you have to know your real mother, which is Holy Spirit, which was also the real mother of Jesus. So Mary was the surrogate mother of Jesus, and Joseph was the foster father. One day I told I went to Oxford, you know, Blackfriars, and over there I told them that Mary was surrogate mother. They laughed at me. Then, you know, one of their priests, you know, friar, he said, oh, I went to certain church, you know, over there they had the picture of Mary and somebody holding a tiny nucleus of Jesus trying to put into the womb of Mary. And then I said, Is not that surrogate? He won't say surrogate because nobody has told him, you know, and he is not capable of thinking himself. Like the born blind person, was he told by somebody that this is the answer, this is that? He was thinking from his own head. When you think from your own head, then you are twice born. But if you are just depending upon letter, this man said, that man said, then you are once born and dead in letters. You can't speak anything what is not written. I tell you, you know, in the Nicene Creed, it say, you know, Christ died, Christ rose on third day. In Oxford, I went to met the dean of the theology department. And over there, you know, theology faculty, and asked him, who died on the cross, Jesus or Christ? He said, if personally you ask me, then I would say Jesus died. But officially I can't say anything because Nicene Creed say the other way. So they are men of letters, as dead as their letter teachers. Our Father God blesses you.